Most books about the Silk Road are about art, and they have a lot, they're coffee table books, and they show pictures of the cities of the modern day Silk Road and the buildings that are there. My book is about the documents that were excavated along the Silk Road. And these documents were written on wood, on leather, and also on paper, most importantly on paper. Paper doesn't survive in most places in the world, but it survives along this Taklamakan Desert because it's so dry. And these documents were not written by professional historians. They don't record the deeds of kings. They are random samples from daily life. There are contracts. We can see how much money people borrowed, the kind of interest that they paid. Oh, by the way, you'll be surprised to hear they paid more interest than they were supposed to according to the laws of the Chinese Empire at the time. You can see people going to court and they're suing because one merchant absconded with the property of another merchant and never returned it. There's a woman who, a letter that was found in an abandoned mail bag is from a woman writing to her husband who she berates for abandoning her. And she says she and her daughter are surviving only by tending sheep. I think many of us have a mental vision of a single road connecting Europe with Asia. But when you actually go to these countries, you see nothing like the Appian Way in Rome. In almost every place, there are multiple routes across the desert, maybe around the desert, connecting one oasis to another, multiple routes through the mountains. Nobody at the time in the ancient world referred to the Silk Road. They always just said the northern route around the Taklamakan, or the southern route around the Taklamakan, or maybe they said the road to Samarkand, the road to Chang'an, the Chinese capital. The word Silk Road, the Silk Road, was coined in 1877 by a German geographer. So it's really a neologism. And it's not that accurate. Silk was not the only, certainly not the only good traveling. There was more things than silk traveling on the Silk Road, and there was not a single road. There were many different routes across Eurasia.